your boy, Tuan Jr. Y'all know the name. But yeah, I'm here to make the predictions on the fight. So first, you got Jaden. Long, linky dude, athletic, pretty quick. Feel me? I ain't really seen him fight a lot, but he pretty cool. Then you got Dante. Dante, he quick. He quick. He's surprisingly quick. And you're going to see that in the fight. But I don't know who I'm going to go with because they both got pretty good athletic skills and abilities. So I'm going to have to say, I don't know. We're going to have to see for that one. So you got Dom and David. Dom and David. Dom, you feel me? He want to be a boxer, so I don't know. And David, that's my dude. He don't really box, but we're going to have to go with David. No, we're going to have to go with Dom on that one. And me and who that dude name? Oh, yeah, me and Rob. Me and Rob, we're going to see.
Cultured ones. So we're back with the video, finally, after the predictions video, I think, or the press conference video. And we're finna, this is the fight predictions video. And these are my predictions for the fights coming up. I'm going to do mine last, obviously. So the first fight of the night is me. So we're going to skip past that for now. The next fight is Dante versus Jaden, which I think could be the best fight of the night. Because, like, how they match up. Jaden's, like, a long... See, Dante is going to have to deal with the height, though. The height is a big difference, bigger than what it was for Dom and Jaden, and it was a factor. So, I think Dante has the more technical fighter. He's fought Dom twice. He's used to it. Jaden's only opponent so far was Kyle, and he sparred Dom. I think Dante wins that fight, but I think it's going to be a good fight. I think it's going to be close. Next, we got Dom and David, the fight everyone's been waiting for. It's been hyped up for a long time, actually, and it's finally happening. I think Dom's got the experience, he's got the size, he's got the reach. I just don't see a way David wins this fight, honestly. I think David does have the speed advantage, and I think he's going to... I just don't know if David will have the cardio to hold up. They're doing 5 rounds, 2 minutes, 5 rounds, 3 minutes. So, and then last, I think I'm going to go for me, Antoine. I don't see a way Tuan Jr. beats me, honestly. I got the size, I got the reach. I sparred multiple times. I think I'm the better just boxer in general. It is headgear. The first two fights are headgear, so I think they both go to decision. And I think I win pretty easily all 3 rounds. I think it's a dominant victory, to be honest.
Yo, what's good, my boys? Just got to practice. Hot as hell, about to get in the pool, you feel me? Living life. But anyway, man, I'm just hopping on, you feel me? Make a little prediction video. Hold on, let me set this boy up real quick. Hold up. Yes, sir. But anyway, just making a little prediction video. It's my boy's fighting. First off, we got Robin Twine. Feel me? I don't really know who I got on that one. I don't know. I ain't never really seen Twine fight before, so I don't know. But he is small, so he should be quick, but I don't know. But if I had to say, I don't know. I ain't never seen Twine fight before, so you gotta show me something. So right now I'm about to say Rob. So I don't know. I ain't never seen Twine fight before, so I don't know. I can't really say anything. But if I had to choose, I'm gonna say Rob. And next thing, got my boy David, my boy Dom. Honestly, I ain't really got much to say on that. You feel me? There's things called weight class. You feel me? David's small as hell, so I ain't really ever seen him box before. And then Dom, he actually trained boxing. He actually take boxing seriously, so. I'm gonna take my boy Dom on that one. And main card, my fight, you feel me? Me and Dante. All respect to my boy Bonte, you feel me? Good fighter. But you know, I got confidence all in myself, you feel me? I feel like I'm gonna win. So yeah, there go your predictions, man. And you feel me? There you go. Yes, sir.
Here are gonna be my predictions for the fight, okay? First, I'm gonna start with Rob and Tuan, okay? So I think Rob has definitely a really like dynamic boxing knowledge, and he's really like a technician, I guess is the word, and he's really like form based. And Tuan is really like, he's gonna have, I think, raw power and a lot more quickness, and it's really gonna come down to who just lands more shots, because it's gonna come down to the points and the judges. But whoever overflows who and figures out the other. I think it's really, whoever, like, that can really go either way, in my opinion. But I think I'm going to have to go with Tuan. I think he's just going to, it'll be close to one round two. I think round three, it'll just be, I think Tuan's going to start taking over a little bit. And it might be a good fight. We'll see. For the second fight, it is Dom and David. And that fight, it's going to be a good fight. And David, he has been working a lot, and he's been working out a lot. He's been training boxing, training how to just spar. Like, he's been doing stuff. And I know Dom has too. They've both been in the gym working on their technique, boxing, you know, everything. And I'm ready for it. And if I really had to make a prediction, I really don't know. I think it's going to be a good fight. I think Dom has a size advantage, and he has the boxing technique. But I don't know, something apart, something, I don't know, something, David is just, I don't know. I've seen David fight, and he has a little man's mentality and a little man's killer mentality. And people might say I'm biased, but I've seen it. And I know Dom is a very tactical and efficient fighter. But we'll see. I think David's very stronger, very much stronger than he looks. And I think Dom's going to underestimate it a little bit. And when he gets in there, he's going to be like, oh, I feel like, and we'll see. I could be wrong, but honestly, I think it's going to go all three rounds. No knockouts here. And I'm taking, go either way. It's going to be points. I think David's going to be the quicker fighter. He's going to be evading more. He's going to be getting more tactical points, but I think he's going to land more. So I think I'm going to give it to David. And for me and Jaden, my fight. You know, my fight. I'm obviously confident. I think I'm going to win. And I think it's going to go all three rounds. I obviously respect my brother, Jaden. He's a tall and lean fighter. I have coming in with the game plan. And I'm expecting to execute. And we'll see come fight day.
All right. What's up, guys? It's your boy, Kyle, out here. I've been told to make a prediction for all three fights. All right. So fight number one. I think it's Dante and Jaden. I don't know. I think as someone who fought Jaden, I think what Dante needs to do is just press him as hard as he can. Jaden's defense is very standstill. Like, he will literally stand there. I think if Dante just pushes that, which we've seen him do against Dom, I think Dante will take that win. But if Jaden plays the length game, because he's a lengthy guy, I think Jaden could have him beat there. So, honestly, I'm saying I have faith in Dante. Next fight, Rob and Antoine Jr. I haven't seen a lot out of Antoine Jr., honestly. I think I only saw one spar. It could really go either way. Rob's landed a couple nice hits. I think he knows what he's doing. So, since I haven't seen anything from Antoine Jr., I'll say Rob. And then the other fight is Dom and David. Big fight. I haven't seen anything out of David either. No working out, no anything. Which, who knows, maybe he's moving in silence. We don't know. But I have seen Dom. We saw him beat Dante. And I think if Dom just executes whatever it is he wants to execute, I think he could pull through. But at the same time, I have no idea what to expect out of David. So, could really go either way, but since I haven't seen anything from David, my guess would have to go towards Dom. Good luck to everybody that's fighting, and yeah.
Yo! The TCO prediction. Man, this is a tough one. This is a very tough one. I feel like two out of three of these matches could go either way. But first off, we got Rob versus Tuan Jr. I think it's really going to come down to, because Tuan Jr. is going to pressure him. He's going to bring that pressure. He's going to head down, swinging overhands. But Rob, I know Rob's got a game plan to deal with that. And if Rob can execute and do the game plan, I think this goes to Rob. But if Rob can't handle the pressure, it's going to get a little rough, because Rob's not ever handled that much pressure, because Kyle's not a pressure fighter. And when I sparred him, I did put a little bit of pressure on.
but it's not like what Tuan's gonna do. But so it all comes down to how Rob handles the pressure. If he handles it well, he gets the dub, I feel. Next up, we got Dante and Jaden. Dante and Jaden, this is a tough one, man. I sat thinking for a bit. You know, Jaden cooked. He cooked Kyle. And Dante had close fights with me every single time. I just think Dante's got the more experience. He's got, you know, because he fought me 3 times. And I think when it comes down to it, Dante's, you know, he's ready. He's done this before. He's been here. He's ready. I think Dante's going to get a lot of shots, like a lot of good body shots that, you know, that surprise you because you don't think they're going to land. And it's a little hard to hit them. So I'm going to edge it towards Dante. I think Dante is going to win. Because plus also Jaden's going to do 4 rounds this time. And throwing those heavy punches like that, it gets difficult. And then me and David. You know, I don't know what to expect from David. But at the same time, 5 rounds, 3 minutes each round. I think I just have the cardio to outlast him. And, you know, the technical IQ for, you know, I think I got the power. I think I get it done 3rd, 4th round. I think I get him out of here. But yeah, that's my predictions. So yeah.
Rob versus Antoine. You know I gotta go with my man Rob. I've been hearing about his boxing skills and I'm so excited I get to see it, you know, in live action. I don't know who Antoine is. No disrespect to you, but you can't handle my boy Rob. He's him. You must not know him if you think you can beat him. I'm not gonna lie. See, Dante, I thought he had a good chance against Dom. I honestly thought he won the last fight. I thought he was tagging him up. But Jaden, he's something different, man. He messed up Kyle. He got some real power behind the punches. So does Dante, but Jaden got the length. I don't know. I feel like he might be a little bit faster than Dante. So it's a tough one, but I think I might have to go with my boy Jaden. I really like the way... I really like what I saw from him against Kyle. Now, Dom and Kyle aren't the same, you know, opponent. So, it's very different, but I just think Jaden going to keep Dante at an arm's length and, you know, box him out. So, for the fight, Dom versus David. Obviously, I got my man Dom, bro. David's like 4 feet tall. Why would I have him in the fight? So, those are my picks. I got Dom and I got Rob, two of my boys. David, I only wish the worst for you, bro.
Yo, what's going on? It's Big Mike, the Man Cave Podcast, y'all favorite sports podcast. If it ain't, give it a listen. Listen, TCO, the Culture Ones, done. Got a notification, had to pull over the side of the road. Got a notification off YouTube saying they got another main boxing event going on. Let's see this here. We got Rob, Patriots fan, Boston Celtics, better win game 6, man, Shredell versus Tawan Jr. All right, so you got the big man versus the smaller man, but speed. Who's going to win this? 3 rounds. Listen, here's the deal. I think it's going to go the distance. And I think Tawan Jr. gets it, but don't. Do not count Big Rob out. He gets one haymaker in there. One. Putting you lights out. That can happen. Second fight. You got Dante versus Jaden. Both of them can fight. Both of them have the skill. Both of them look good. They look prime for this. I think it goes the distance again. 4 rounds. I think Dante gets it in the end. That heart, he's got it. And I've seen it, and it's crazy. I think he gets it in 4. Decision. Main card. 5 rounds. The kid, Dominic, versus the wild card, David. I don't know much about the wild card. I've never seen a fight. Don't know him. But I believe the kid, my son, and it's not me being biased. I've seen him work. I know how he gets when he gets aggressive about something. He gets his mind set on something. He's ready to go. He's putting a lot to this. He has something there, something going on. I think in the third round, he knocks him out. First round, they feel each other out. Second round, you know, wild card might try to get a couple haymakers in there. He knows it's coming. Third round, Don puts a couple 1-2s together, then overhand right, and that's all she said. But that's what I believe happens. Again, subscribe. Give my boys the culture ones, my young men here, these young fellas, subscribe to them. Again, the culture ones. And give us, the Man Cave, a listen. Holla at y'all.
It's funny, the shit I put on the song ain't gonna sound nothing like the shit we've been doing. Yeah. I just been baddest bitches to the baddest. Baddest money on the dime. I say, I don't need no Molly to be savage. When I'm on that Molly, I feel savage. She the definition of a bad bitch. Stole her. I'm the definition of a bandit.